say he raped you twice? Why didn't you tell the cops?
Because he'd say that he didn't have to force me the second time. See, the second time, I let him do it. Just gonna stand there. Aren't you gonna yell at me or anything?
The other day, when you were talking about us wanting to start a family, you knew you were pregnant then, didn't you? What were you trying to do to me? Make me think it was mine.
I was gonna get rid of it.
Yeah, but only after I said that we ought to wait. If I'd said okay, you'd let me go on thinking I was the father, wouldn't you?
No.
Wouldn't you?
No. Well, I thought about it for a second. But I was real scared, Kevin. I didn't know if you'd understand or not.
You didn't even give me a chance, Doreen. You know, and the next thing I know that you're telling me you were raped. Was that a story too?
No!
Well, what am I supposed to think? I mean, one minute you tell me you're raped, the next thing you never forced you at all.
You weren't listening. It was only later on that I said...
I could have killed that guy. You know that? I could have killed him for what he did to you. Because I believed you.
I wasn't lying, honest. Well, not about him raping me anyhow. And I only went along with him the other time so that you'd get that delivery job.
What job?
The one I rang you about, and you would have got it too, except Mrs. Davidson put a stop to it. I had to find out what all the others were offering so that you could put in the best bid.
Do you mean that you did that with him, to get me a job?
Well, you said you weren't doing too good.
Is that what you think of me, that I'm so bloody useless I can't even find my own work?
Well, Doreen doesn't think that, Kevin. Surely you must know that.
Oh, yeah, all right. All right, Mr. Jackson, you all seem to know her better than I do. Are you saying that the next time I'm out of work or things get a bit rough, she's not going to do the same thing again?
How can you say that? I wouldn't.
Well, I don't know when you're telling me the truth anymore, Doreen.
What do you mean, Kevin? Don't you believe me? Well, bugger you then. If that's the way you feel, I never want to see you again.
It's hard enough in the first few months of marriage at the best of times, but when you're separated...
Look, what
like
are you
this...
saying, Mrs. Jackson, that I'm wrong?
No, what I'm saying is that you need a lot more understanding and patience.
Oh, I've tried that ever since I met her.
You knew it wasn't going to be easy.
Yeah, but it's the way she went about it. I mean, doesn't she know when she's lying anymore? You might be used to that sort of thing around here, but I'm not. I don't know if I can take it anymore.
Can't be easy for him.
They've been through more than most people have in a lifetime. Mm.
Could you bring Doreen to my office, please? I think it's time I had a word with her. Oh, and keep an eye on White. I've sent her back with the other women.
Liz, are you playing this game or not?
Hey?
I asked you for 3 cards. Oh, listen, Doreen and Kevin have got to sort this out for themselves, and worrying about it is not going to help.
I thought you said they'd chuck her in solitary.
She must have more of a gift of the gab than I thought. Made mincemeat of you every time.
Only because she catches me off guard.
I think we should call it a truce. What do you say, Margot? You only have to put up with me for a few more days, just until my trial. So no more trouble, okay?
You're the one that needs to remember that.
You're not gonna let her get up.
Hey, Dor. What you sitting over there all by yourself for? Did you work everything out? Did you talk about what you're gonna do with the baby? Then what did you talk about?
Told him the truth and he never believed me.
What'd I tell you, bloody men? The minute you mention rape, they think it has to be the woman's fault. Now, if you'd done as I told you and told him it was his, you'd be all right now.
Look, if I hadn't listened to all of you in the first place, I wouldn't have gotten so mixed up. Now he thinks I'm a rotten little liar.
Now, just let's back up a minute. If anybody gave you advice, it's because you asked for it. Or because they care for you.
My door. Kev really loves you.
Told him I never want to see him again.
Door!
But I'm gonna see him tomorrow and tell him I never meant it. He's gotta believe me.
God, did your day release come through?
No.
Then would you mind telling us what's going through that thick skull of yours?
I'm going over the fence. And nobody's gonna stop me.
It was real easy last time we got over the fence. You might even be back before they missed you.
Yeah, all we got to do is keep the screws busy.
And I'm going to go with you, Dor. Just make sure Kevin listens to you.
What do you think you're all doing for crying out loud? I've been trying to talk some sense into the girl, and you're all egging her on. Look, you have done nothing but talk to him. Do you think he's going to thank you for breaking out just so you can go over old ground?
Yeah, it'll be different this time. At least we won't have a screw breathing down our necks, and it'll just prove to him how much I love him. Anyhow, we'll only be gone a couple of hours.
Even if it's only for a couple of seconds, you break out, you'll get another 6 months. Now, what good is that going to do your marriage?
Yeah, Dor. We want you to stay together. We don't want you to break up.
Well, thank you, Lizzie. At last, I'm getting through to someone.
Yeah, but if he doesn't believe me and I lose him, I may as well be stuck in here.
Listen, honey. You know, when Noeline was knocked up in that storeroom, well, we got her out of there, and that took over 12 hours. I mean, we won't even be gone that long. It'll be a breeze.
Yeah, Bea. Please, I'll never ask anything of you again.
Yeah, Bea. It might not be as tough as you reckon.
I don't believe this. I mean, I really don't believe it.
I think you should all believe in what you see. You got a point there, Kay.
Mrs. Davidson wants to see you, Doreen.
Mrs. Jackson, look, we all know Doreen's got a few problems. Is there any chance of getting a day release tomorrow?
Well, that's up to Mrs. Davidson.
But couldn't you put a good word in for her?
I can't promise anything, B.
Okay, what's the big idea?
Just want to help the kid, you know, see if she gets back in time.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I'm all heart.
No, the department has not approved your application yet, Doreen.
You could hurry him up, couldn't you, Mrs. Davidson?
Under the circumstances, I don't think that would be wise. At the moment, you and Kevin are under a great deal of emotional strain.
Yeah, but that's only because we haven't talked things out properly.
You have already had more than your allowed number of visits, Doreen, and to date, they have only aggravated the situation.
It might be best to let things settle down. I mean, if you saw him now, it could make matters worse.
I know what you've been going through these last few days, and I'm very proud of the way you've been coping. I am also aware that you and Kevin have a big decision ahead of you. Now, there are grounds for an abortion, but I think it's important that you both have time alone to think about it. Perhaps then you might be able to discuss it calmly. Do you think that makes sense?
Yeah.
Very well. You may go. It might do some good if I had a word with Kevin myself.
Well, it's worth a try, because every time Doreen tries to explain, it sounds horrifying. No wonder Kevin's confused. They both are.
You know, David could be right.
I'm going to make it up to him, Bea. Well, he's got to know that I'll do anything he says. And if he wants me to have that baby, then I'm having it, and I don't care whose it is.
You really mean that, love?
I just don't want Kevin hating me.
Hey, will you give Josie a ring in hospital while you're out?
Knock it off, will you, Lizzie? You've got 4 hours. You go straight there and back, and no detours. And don't you dare be 1 second late.
How are we going to stop the screws from finding out?
Now, how the hell should I know that? You're the ones that think up these harebrained schemes. They expect me to get you out of them.
Oh, you'll think of something, Bea. You always do.
Oh, yeah.
It's okay. Jude will look after me.
You're taking quite a risk, aren't you? Surely Doreen can do it on her own.
Well, I just want to see that Kevin talks to her and she gets back on time.
And what about you?
What about me?
Something tells me you've got other plans, and they don't include getting back in time. Not that I blame you. Thank God I'll be out of here in a few days.
You seem pretty sure of yourself.
I have to be. If I thought I was going to be stuck in this place, I'd
go mad. You know something, Kay? You better watch out for yourself. You put on too good an act, you're liable to end up in a padded cell.
They're only treating me for compulsive gambling.
Yeah. Well, what are you going to do when the screws tell the doctor that you've been bashing up Marga?
Out on the board, the old sheriff stands, clutching shears in his old bony hands, fixes his gaze on a blue-belly Joe. Glory if he makes it to make the ring a go. Click, go the shears, boys, click, click, click. Glory, 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 glory,
The ringer looks around at his big fire blow and curses the old snagger with the bear.